Well, 9 years ago, our next guest was preparing for her daughter's birthday when a sudden illness nearly killed her. Mandy McCracken survived sepsis and was released from hospital 10 months later, without her forearms and her lower legs, which were amputated as a result of the disease.
Yeah, but that really hasn't stopped her from doing much at all. And she's even returned to her former favourite hobby, indoor rock climbing. Mandy joins us now from Melbourne. Mandy, it's such a pleasure to speak to you. Can you take us back to the beginning and when you fell ill initially? What happened there?
Well, I just felt like I was coming down with the flu, actually. I went to bed for a couple of days and on a Friday, all hell broke loose and I started vomiting up blood and it was all pretty horrible and we called an ambulance and I ended up in a coma for 10 days with a streptococcal A infection. And sepsis is what I got. So I lost both my hands below the elbow and I lost both my legs below the knee.
How did you handle that? Because that's a lot of loss.
The whole thing has been really hard work mentally, but I've learnt that the beauty of black humour, laughing through the whole thing, has made a massive difference. Even when I was in ICU, I came up with the idea of naming all my gadgets. So I've got Alana and Alan are my two prosthetic hands. My legs are called Standing and Kneeling. We have a lot of fun. You know, we've included the kids in that black humour and it's got us through. It's actually been really good.
Yeah, that gallows humour always tends to work, doesn't it? You actually can't see this picture, but we're showing everyone at home a photo of you dressed as a zombie bride. Halloween. It's coming fairly soon.
One of our finest moments.
This is brilliant. You just mentioned that black humour is really important to your family. How did the kids react to seeing you dressed up?
Oh, look, that was a great day. We put a lot of effort into getting changed and dressed up for Christmas. Halloween over in America. We ran around the neighbourhood and honestly the entire neighbourhood got completely freaked out because they really just couldn't work out why my hands were missing and why there was a set of hands tied around my husband's tie next to me. So, the more fun you can have with it, it makes it really comfortable for everybody else as well. It means that they can laugh with us rather than just sort of being a bit freaked out by the situation. So, there's certainly a lot of healing to be done in that laughter, I think.
I've been reading about the Quad Squad. Can you tell us what that is and how it came about?
So when I was in hospital, a fellow called Matthew Ames, who was actually in Brisbane, he's a quadruple amputee and he lost his arms and legs before me, about a year before I did. And I actually saw him on TV one night when I was in hospital. And we got in contact with him and eventually met him up at a pub up in Queensland. And he brought another quadruple amputee friend along, Corinne Barrett. And we sat there and we had three quadruple amps. We had all our families sitting there and we laughed and there were great stories that nobody else had lived through. Things that our family had to deal with, the kids had to deal with. And it was all normal. We're sitting around this table in this massive pub and we had literally body parts all over the table and for all our family members that was finally normal. And we said to each other, we've got to stay in touch. And sure enough, over the time, we've actually had new quadruple amputees come along and every time we hear of a new one, we get in touch with them. And we started up a Facebook page and now we've got, I think it's about 400 quadruple amputees around the world, quite a few from COVID, unfortunately. And we get in touch, we get together. I started up a conference where I bring everyone together every couple of years. And it's just literally sharing tips and ideas on prosthetics and NDIS and dealing with, blisters on your amputated leg and, that sort of stuff. And I'm actually hoping to get up a whole group called the My New Life Disability Support Program. So anyone who's dealing with a new disability can get in touch with someone else in their local area, in your neighbourhood, so that you can ask questions like, how do you get on a train with a wheelchair? I'd never done that before. I was 39 years old and I wanted to take the kids to a movie, but how do you get an electric wheelchair onto a country train? And I'd had no one to ring. I didn't know who to ask. So So I've started up, hopefully I'm going to get this group up and running, and I'd love to see it Australia-wide. So anyone who has a new disability or a child born with a disability can meet people in their neighbourhood and ask these sorts of questions.
Oh, that is so brilliant. Mandy, you mentioned before that you've named your prosthetics, you've given them all names.
Yes.
Can you show us how your bionic arms work? I think you've got all that there ready to show us.
So, hang on, I've got this one turned off. Let me turn it back on. So they open and close when they work. They behave some days and some days they don't. So inside is a little battery. I charge myself up each morning, and so it's got like a mobile phone battery, and they've got electrodes that sit on my skin. So if I take this off, my skin has a couple of little electrodes that sit on it, and I just flex my muscle just the same as you would flex your wrist backwards and forward.
Wow.
And there's an electrode inside that picks up that muscle movement and allows me to open and close. So I can drive with these. I can probably do up a shoelace if I really needed to. But things like just eating, you know, going to the toilet, which is always what we're... The most important thing is that you can go to the bathroom by yourself. Mm. But they've been fantastic. And I've got a whole set, as you can see, I've got a whole set of prosthetics. Everything does different things. I've actually got one here. Let me see if I can pop this on. I'm going to take this off.
Would you need different prosthetics as well to rock climb, Mandy?
Yeah, so if you think of these prosthetics as like tools, mm-hmm. so you would use, you know, a hammer to do one job and a screwdriver to do another.
Yeah.
So I've got this fantastic little arm.
Wow.
That
wow.
means that I can put on a very big scary kitchen knife and I can chop the veggies.
Wow. So,
they're great and they're absolutely life-changing. You know, for me to have such a simple gadget means that I can do stuff. And so what I did is I actually went to my prosthetist, Josh, who might be watching. Hello, Josh. And I said to him, I want to get back to climbing. I came across a fellow in America called the No-Handed Bandit, and he was rock climbing with the same amputations that I had. So when I got these made, my prosthetist Alana and Josh, I said to them, you know, will this hold my body weight? And so Alana tried to pull it off, and sure enough, it actually holds my body weight. So all I have to do is stick on one of these hooks, which of course I can't do right now, that's a second set of hands, and I can hang and I can rock climb. So I'm in the process of trying to get some new rock climbing feet made up. And so I went rock climbing with Adaptive Climbing Victoria, and sure enough, just recently I got to the top of a 3-story high rock climbing wall. I got up there twice. So
Mandy,
it's just a matter of using your imagination.
You're incredible, and you're changing lives by being so open and just so approachable and setting up this incredible support group as well. You can listen to Mandy McCracken's podcast, Look Mum No Hands, on the ABC Listen app. Just search Mandy McCracken. And your organisation as well, Mandy, is so brilliant, the Quad Squad. Check it out if you want to get involved. Thanks again for joining us today.
Cheers.
Thank you.
Nice to meet you all. Thanks for having me on.